Hi guys, welcome to Gatematic. In the previous lecture, we have seen how to draw the phasor diagram of YD plus 30 and YD minus 150, that is also known in a clock form, that is YD 11 and YD 5. Now in this lecture, we will start a new connection, that is YD minus 30 and YD plus 150. How to make the YD 1 and YD 7, we will see in this lecture. So let's get started. So this is my fourth point, first, that is how to make a YD minus 30 or YD, it can also be said as YD 1. Okay, so I have to make this winding connection. In the previous lecture, I have already made the YD 1 by taking the first case, but let us draw now also. See here, in a primary is star connected, secondary is delta connected, that is a low voltage winding, and low voltage winding phasor, line to neutral voltage of low voltage winding phasor is lagging behind by 30 degree. So if I will draw the clock notation, then I told you that at 12 high voltage is fixed, it will not rotate, and low voltage side is lagging by minus 30, this is the 30 degree, it is lagging by 30 degree. So definitely it is making 1 o'clock, right? So that's why it is known as YD1. Now draw the winding connection of YD1. How will I draw? So in a star connection, you don't have to do anything. First draw like this, three windings separated, and name it as A2, A1, B2, B1, and C2, C1. And in star connection, what I did? I short circuit this A1, B1, C1. And I name it as neutral, it is connected with neutral, and from A2, B2 and C2, we take supply, this is at A, this is at B, this is at C. So I draw the three phase star connection first. Now in order to make the delta connection, there is problem. Why? Because we don't know which point is connected with which point. Let us say this is A2, A1, B2, B1, C2, C1. Okay, and I am assuming that I am taking supply from A2, B2 and C2, but we don't know whether A2 is connected with B1, B2 is connected with C1, or C2 is connected with A1, or A1 is connected with B2, B1 is connected with C2, or C1 is connected with A2. We don't know this. So we will take one by one. First I will draw the phasor diagram of a star connection. So how the phasor diagram will look like? Let us take, this is my A2. See, A2 is connected with supply, that means this is at high potential. So this is my A2 and this is A1. Similarly, B2, B1 will lag by 120 degree. This is my B2, B1 and this is my C2, C1. Now I told you, while drawing phasor diagram, you have to keep in mind the rule number 3, that is the phase voltage of primary and secondary must be either in same phase or in opposite phase. So let us take first in same phase. So I have to make the winding connection like YD1, means anyhow in clock representation this is 12 and this is 1, means anyhow I have to make the line to neutral voltage of LV side lagging by line to neutral voltage of HV side. I have to make like this. So see the rule number 3. Rule number 3 says A1, A2 must be parallel with high voltage side of A1, A2. So this is fine. I can make this as A2 and A1. This much I can draw without knowing which point is connected with which point, because this A1, A2 must be in phase with A1, A2. Now I have to draw the B1, B2. So there is two case possible. Either I will draw the B1, B2 like this. This is parallel with B1, B2 of HV winding. So this is my B2 and B1. See, this small B2, B1 is parallel with capital letter of B2, B1, means phase voltage is parallel. Okay. In the same way, I can connect like this. This is my C2 and this is my C1. So this is first case possible. And second case is possible like this. Let us connect this A2, A1. And I have to draw the B2, B1 parallel with this B2, B1 of HV side. So I can draw like this. This is also parallel with B2, B1 of HV side. Okay. In the same way, I can connect like this. This is C2 and C1. So these two connections are possible in delta. Are you getting me? If I will take the parallel phase voltage, means A1, A2 are parallel with A1, A2. So if I will consider this, then these two cases are possible. Now see the neutral point. This is my neutral point, and in this case, this is my neutral point. Make the line to neutral phasor first. So line to neutral phasor of A will be somehow like this. This is connected with A2, and here line to neutral phasor of A will be somehow like this. This is my A. I am taking both the cases parallelly. Now see, if I will take this diagram, then connect both the neutral of HB and LB. This is the HB neutral and this is my LV neutral. So connect at same point, you will get this is the A1, A2. This is my A2 and this is my A1 and this is at 12. We already know that line to neutral voltage of HB side is fixed at 12. We know this. Now draw this a small a. It will be somehow here. It is lagging by 30 degree. This is my small a. In clock notation, this is at 1, means by considering this phasor, what we are getting? We are getting yd1, or you can say yd-30. So here I have to draw the phasor diagram of yd-30 and I have to connect the winding so that it will give yd-30. Which case I have to take? This case number 1. So this connection is valid for yd-30. Now if I will take this connection, that is case 2, then it will give me yd-11. You can see this is at A and this is my high voltage side A. So in clock notation, if you will see, this will be at 11. So it is making 11 o'clock. So this is my yd-11. I have to make the yd-1, not yd-11. So this connection is not for making yd-1. So what are the connection possible? The connection possible is A2 must be connected with C1, C2 must be connected with B1, and B2 must be connected with A1. So you can connect like A1 is connected with B2. See here, A1 is connected with B2, B1 is connected with C2, and C1 is connected with A2. So this is the connection diagram of yd1, or you can say yd-30. You have to take this phasor. You don't have to take this phasor, because this phasor will give you yd11 that we have seen in the previous lecture. Got it? So finally the phasor will look like this. This is my A2, A1, and here A1 is connected with B2. So this will be my B2, B1, and this will be my C2, C1. And here this is the neutral line to neutral voltage, I can denote like A. So this is the final phasor diagram of yd1 and y, or you can say yd-30. Now I have to make yd7. I have to make the yd7. So see, in case of yd1, this is my HV side, that is fixed at 12, and this is my LV side, and this is at 1. I have to make the yd7. 7 is just opposite to 1, means I have to rotate this LV winding by 180 degree in order to make the yd7, right? So what I will do, I will leave the primary winding as it is, means the phasor diagram of primary winding will be same as the yd1, but in case of LV winding, what I will do, in order to shift this LV from 1 to 7, I have to rotate this LV winding by 180 degree, means I have to change the orientation of LV winding in order to make the yd7. So let us make the yd7. How the yd7 will look like. So first draw the connection diagram of yd7. This is the connection diagram of yd1. Okay. So in order to make the connection diagram of yd7, what I have to do? I have to change the orientation of delta connected, which is at which is in yd1. So this is my A2, A1. This is B2, B1, and C2, C1. So here I have taken the supply from A2, B2, C2. In this case, I will take the supply from A, A1, B1 and C1. Then only I will be able to change the orientation, and I can make the phase shift of 180 degree in order to make yd7, right? So I have changed the supply connection first. Secondly, here A1 is connected with B2, B1 is connected with C2 and C1 is connected with A2 in case of yd1. But in case of yd7, again I have to change here also. What I will do, I will connect just opposite to the first case, that is A2 is connected with B1, B2 is connected with C1, and C2 is connected with A1. Are you getting this? If you know how to make the delta-delta connection that I have given you in the previous lecture, then you can easily understand how I am changing the orientation of this delta connection. I am reversing the supply as well as I am connecting the A2 with B1, B2 with C1, and C2 with A1. Means I am reversing the connection also in order to get the YD7. So this is the connection of YD7 I have made. Now let us check whether this is correct or not. So I can easily check. Now see, since I have changed the orientation of delta connection just opposite to the previous case, means the phase voltage will become anti-parallel. Right, in the previous case it was parallel, now it will become anti-parallel, and we are taking supply from A1, so A1 will be at higher potential, and this is my A2. Let us draw a verb. This is A1 and this is A2. So see, high voltage side A1 A2 is opposite to the low voltage side of A1 A2, means high voltage side of B1 B2 must be opposite to the low voltage side of B1 B2. That is, we are making the opposite anti-parallel phasor in order to get the YD7. So how the B1 B2 will be in this phasor diagram? B1 B2 will be somehow here. This will be my B1 and this will be my B2. Are you getting this? See, this B1 B2 is opposite to this B1 B2. Similarly, I will get C1 C2. This is my C1 and this is my C2. This is also, this phasor is also opposite to the high voltage phasor. Are you getting this? So in this way, I have made the phasor diagram of LV side, or in other word, you can also go through by winding connection also. See here, A2 is connected with B1, means A2 is connected with B1, B2 is connected with C1, B2 is connected with C1, and C2 is connected with A1, C2 is connected with A1, means this phasor diagram is correct. Now draw the line to neutral voltage of A. Line to neutral voltage of A will be somehow here. Make both the neutral at same point. This is my line to neutral voltage of a small a, and this is my line to neutral voltage of capital A, and this is at 12 o'clock, right? Means if I will make this clock, then it will give me, this point will give me 7. Got it? So this is the correct phasor diagram of YD7. We are getting YD7 by using this convention. Okay, so these are the procedure you have to keep in mind. Now let us understand some of the key features in YD1 or YD7. See, the feature will be remain as it is, like we have already seen in previous lecture, that is YD11 and YD5. Feature will be same, because here also a star delta transformer is there, and a star delta transformer we have already found the all the features in the previous lecture. So feature will remain as it is, that is the line to V line of a star connection upon V line of delta connection, that must be equal to root 3 times of V phase of a star connection, and this is V phase of delta connection, because in delta line voltage and phase voltage are equal. So this will come out to be root 3 times of N1 by N2. First features was this we have calculated in the previous lecture, and second features was about harmonics, that is third harmonic current is available in the along the delta side, that is the secondary side. We will get third harmonic current, that means here flux will be sinusoidal and EMF will be sinusoidal. These all things we have seen in the previous lecture only. So features will remain same, only the vector group will change. Here the vector group I am getting YD1 and YD7, and in the previous lecture we got the vector group, that is YD11 and YD5. Okay, so feature will remain same. That's all about this lecture. In the next lecture we will see how to draw the phasor diagram of DY11 and DY5. Okay, and then in the last lecture will contain DY1 and DY7. So these two topics we will see in the next lecture. If you guys understood the concept, then please like this video. Also you can put your doubt in the comment below, or you can ask in query in our Facebook group. For joining this group, what you have to do, type Gatematic Education in the search bar and like this page. This is the Gatematic Education page, and you can join this group. This is the Gatematic Education group. Click on this and click on join icon. Got it?